On forecasting scheduling, I'll just take you to the back. In 2010, they have initially started with regulatory fund, renewable regulatory fund, which they were saying plus minus 30% will allow, after that 10, 15 paisa, 30 paisa, like that. So that was strongly objected across the nation. So that was withdrawn. In Maharashtra, for example, if you're talking about last year, it was proposed. Many people have objected, coordinating agency, many people objected on 5 megawatt cap. Because, you know, what happened in Maharashtra, typically, from 1998 to 2003, there were very small machines, 230 kilowatt, 250 kilowatt, 350 kilowatt. So even if I have 15 machines of 250 kilowatt, I am still below that 5 megawatt cap. So I am free from any forecasting. But that substation, which is having hundreds of machines, and only few are crossing that 5 megawatt, and they are allowed to have, they are now coming into cap of forecasting regulating. So as a substation, SLDC want forecasting from substation. So in substation, you have 90% of the people who are not in forecasting. So the entire substation is not operating as per the demand and supply requirement. That is the main practical issue, because they are out of regulation in as they are less than 5 megawatt. And if now initially the metering was on the meter side, now they have shifted to common meter. Now again recently last year MSEDCL want meter on the wind generator individual machines. So individual machines, SLDC cannot, there is no visibility of that meter for SLDC. So they are not able to keep a track how much generation they are getting. So actual generation availability for SLDC is also an issue. That's a problem, practical issue. So it is not that only wind generators or solar generators are not understanding this point, but practical ability or implementation point of view, this creates an issue. Because now if you have seen yesterday, it has rained in Aurangabad. Nobody has forecasted. So the entire solar generation must have dropped down. SLDC point of view, it is correct that grid cannot take that much of impact, because suddenly the generation has dropped down. So that point, definitely the IPPs and the generators understand. But then it has to be a win-win situation for everyone. It is not to be like a parent-child transaction, that they want that this way only, do whatever you want. But then we're not going to adjust it. So I think we have to somewhere fine-tune this. And since MEDA is a promoting agency for that, and it's very lucky to have MEDA, MSEDCL, and IPPs together in this platform. So I think we and grid curtailment on agriculture feeder, we're pointing out there are a lot of projects coming on rural feeder, but they are coming into load shedding pattern of MERC as per declared load shedding pattern. And wind and solar energy has given must-run status as per the national grid policy. So they have to run by hook or crook. You cannot stop solar or wind generation. But because it is coming into the substation where it is a load shedding pattern, those generations are put off, though they can able to generate. It's a national loss. You cannot have yesterday's sun today, or you cannot have today's sun tomorrow. It's gone, it's gone. You cannot have wind today, wind tomorrow. So it's gone, it's gone. So when we are talking about rural feeder going in for agriculture feeder in chief minister scheme or anything like that, there are a lot of generation now. Girasesar is putting 200 megawatt in rural feeder. But if those substations are cut off from the grid, where the generation will go? Even if it is implemented at 3 rupees or 350, there is no generation, so MSEDCL will not pay. So considering the time, I think, Anand, we have to conclude this. So I'll just sum up. It's very interesting session. For me to summarize, because initially when the wind and solar were very less, it was red carpet given by MEDA and MSEDCL. Nobody can deny that. It was a very grand welcome by MSEDCL, that point of view. We are talking about 1998 or 2000. The grid, the wind projects and initial solar projects were welcome, because the penetration was very, very less. The moment now we have gone up to large scale, we have to also see from MSEDCL point of view. For a time being, Tirupalliwasar, I am wearing hat of MSEDCL. I'm talking in favor of you. So from MSEDCL point of view, we have to also see that so much of wind generation and so much of solar generation coming to the grid stability is a problem, because SLDC cannot forecast any demand and supply. The thermal generation cannot ramp down and up immediately. So we have to continue with the thermal generation. We have to also take solar and wind generation into the grid. But there has to be some mechanism, though forecasting scheduling is a mechanism, but accuracy is a point problem. In other countries, the accuracy is up to 1% or less than 1%. But in India, unfortunately, we are not going to that accuracy level. And till that time accuracy level is achieved, I think penalty charges should have been waived off or have been reduced. I think that is the way forward for going into the forecasting scheduling. Definitely it is required. We are talking about, there are so many problems are immediately faced. Now, for example, customer point of view, where you are implementing KVH metering from immediately now from April onwards. So power factor is withdrawn, incentive is withdrawn. Now suppose there is a generation adjustment for open access, they will also have the generation in KVH because consumer is KVH and you are measured in KWH. So again, the meters will have to be changed at the generation level. The solar generator, solar park, you have to have the KVH factor also coming in. And KVH can be adjusted. So that's again a challenge. Harmonics, they are putting it for consumer. Again, I don't know whether some point up down the lines after 6 months, they will also put harmonic analysis for solar generation. Nobody can deny that because harmonic is a technical factor and has to have, we have to have the pure sine wave for grid. There is no doubt on that. But then they are happening so fast, that is where there is a clash. The as rightly pointed out by Gaurav, we have to have some consistent policy. Okay, this is the policy, next 5 years, there will be no changes in that. So then people can plan, because the moment people start conceptualizing the project and the point they are implementing it, the regulations is completely changed. Now people are only talking about 4.9 megawatt because they are out of forecasting scheduling. That is the sad part of it. People who can invest more than 5 megawatt, they said, don't want to go for forecasting scheduling. Let us keep it 4, 4.5 megawatt so that they are out of forecasting scheduling mechanism. The problem that there are many multiple 4.5 megawatt, the grid is also affected. They are not coming into forecasting scheduling, but then multiple projects at lesser 5 megawatt, they will still affect the grid. SLDC will again have a problem, again have a headache. Their grid solar generators are creating problem because you cannot, the solar, you cannot imagine from only daytime it is available. Similarly for wind, you never know when the wind will blow. So in Tamil Nadu also, they have done a very interesting study about large penetration into the grid. And they have also introduced that RKVH charges and other things. So in generation also, wind generation, solar generation, there is an issue of reactive power. From MSED cell point of view, it is correct. It is a survival issue for them. Large paying consumers are going away. They are putting their own generation and they are the revenue is getting lost from MSED cell. They are worried about their own revenue because they are forecasting some ARR and that actual at the end of the year, they are not getting that revenue because that in between, a lot of large consumers are putting solar plant on their rooftop. Like Fiat has put more than 4 megawatt and they are not net metering. So it is not recognized or not registered with MSED cell at all. The demand will certainly come down. That is why MSED cell also had put one new suggestion that 80% of the demand will be charged, whether you are consuming or not. That's a counter step from MSED cell to keep that demand charges up. Because initially it was 50%, though if you are using the maximum demand only up to 50%, you are charged 50%. But now, if you have put a solar or wind in captive, or if you put a solar rooftop, and if your contract demand has reduced to 30% or 40% maximum demand, you are still charged with 80%. So they are ensuring that you are paying. The consumer is paying minimum demand charges which they have anticipated for because their demand is there. And when actual demand is not fulfilled, the net revenue is also getting lost. They are only getting demand charges, but not on the energy charges. So what is happening? It is like a tennis player. You know, he's putting some forehand shot, he's been putting backhand shot. Then there is something rally happening for longer time, there is nothing happening. Then suddenly some spin comes and then the person, opposite person, then suddenly go out of court. And then he start to regain his energy and again want to come back in the court and start playing again. Now it is your turn for serve. So sometime MSED cell serve, sometime MEDA serve, sometime the solar generator serve. The problem is that they are always on the opposite side of each other, which is a sad state of affair. And now the time has come that everybody started on the same point of same side of the story and play a game where everybody has to play together, not opposite to each other. And there will be always point till last 20, 25 years I am into this field of renewable energy. There was always a point that MSED cell is not supporting, MEDA, the procedure is not correct, the wind generators are not getting whatever they are asked for, the solar generators are getting pain because of so many issues. I have started with initially feed-in tariff was so high, they have charged 19 rupees, now it has the reverse bidding has come to 250, there is no bidding. Now the period which is the tenure is over, last 8 years and 13 years PPA is over, they are put in limbo. They are not given only open access, because open access means MSED cell problem, their consumer will go away. So they have put a bottleneck. They went to MERC and they say 252, we are putting a cap on the tariff. The wind energy tariff, they are, till this time, the 13-year PPA, they were getting 585. You can imagine the situation. In the month of March, I am getting 585 for my wind generation, and from April, I am getting 252. So what is this psyche? Anybody want money? That's not an, there is nothing wrong in that. Though money is being considered as a bad word, but it is not. Because everybody is putting the project or the business for getting the revenue. Nobody is doing for charity. Now, unfortunately, the solar and wind project has not become any technology or any technical subject. It has become purely finance subject now. Everybody is struggling to get his revenue back. Everybody wants to have his cash flow strengthened because there are a lot of investment coming from the other countries also. And they are worried. If it is the NPA, if the MSEDC is not paying their dues, then they have to answer somewhere. Their equity is under problem. Their debt are under problem. So everybody is right. Like what has happened sometime in cricket matches, everybody has played well, but result is that our team has lost. That should not happen. Unfortunately, since you are here, Dumre sir and Thagal Palliwar sir, both are here, I can take this opportunity that let us work in synergy with each other. Let us not consider each other as opponent. You know, not do some hidden war. If you are doing a lot of projects are coming up, let me find out something which we can cut your projects. And from solar generator point of view also, let us not do that MSEDC ko, consumers ko, kaise bhi karke revenue lena hai, because investment is coming from the large consumers. There is no doubt they are giving. And on top of it, central government, they have given like a test match in cricket. You know, we are waiting for five days match. Let play, no problem. Play honestly, play technically, play it with a good stance. But instead, we are always fighting with 20-20 matches. So how it can matter? The batsman is playing with the mindset of 5 days match and the bowler is bowling with 20-20 overs. So unfortunately, this is the state. So let us, the time has come. I think I'll request Anand also. So since we have got a good churning of the thoughts, let us put it a thought together and see how we can move in synergy forward. That will conclude the session. Thank you very much for everyone. He has already put a pointer, no time. No time. We'll have it later. One point? Okay.
So, one of the good things, MEDA is coming with the hybrid policy, and that hybrid policy will help us for the grid stability as well, because with the solar, rather than with the solar, we are getting the wind in the hybrid project, and in future, definitely along with the hybrid, we'll get the storage. So, proper forecasting, that in the forecasting and scheduling in the future will be help out because of this hybrid policy, and we are expecting that things from MEDA.
Yeah, I think there are some good moves are happening, like REMC, Regional Energy Management Centers. Yesterday, Central Minister has announced 11 REMC to be implemented. So that's a way forward for forecasting. There is also a draft available, if you are aware, that thermal and RE together, how we can do it. Because scheduling, you have to have thermal and RE going jointly together. As we are talking about generator, MSEDC and MEDA going together, thermal and RE also has to work together, because you have RE for only certain part of the time, thermal has to continue. You cannot replace thermal with RE, that is for sure. So we have to have some mechanism where we can have, like hybrid, he just now mentioned, we have solar wind complementing each other. We have storage also coming in the way. So storage also, there is some policy regulatory issues which has to come. Because whether it has to be done storage on utility scale, or generator has to do storage, or consumer has to do storage, I think that issue is still not clear. Though the costing definitely is a problem today, that will definitely be available in coming for 4-5 years, the cost will come down. But generator, you can imagine the situation. Those who are only single generator today, large IPPs, can think of hybrid plus storage together so that they can challenge any forecasting. They can put the storage on and they can use this entire capacity as available scheduled power available in the grid, so that grid is also stable. MSEDC will not have any issue. If I told 10 units I'll generate, I'll definitely doing 10 units. If I'm telling 10 and generating only 1, they have an issue. If I'm telling 10 and generating 20, also they have an issue. We have to also think from their point of view. We have to also think MEDA, of course, is like a priest or a bhajji who want to marry, but then they are chanting the mantras all the time, so that both parties has to marry and for the longer life. But then sometime the couple itself start fighting. So on this note, positive note that, okay, there is a challenging and there is a promising way ahead. And is there any time for questions or we can? So I hope all questions are answered by the panelists. So thank you very much. Thank Anand.
As for questioners, I would like to thank you as bankers who are giving loan to MSEDCL. Think from that point of view, most of your questions would be solved.
So thank you, Anand and EQ, and thank you all the panelists. It was a very valuable and thoughtful discussion. Nothing personal about it. It's just a thought. So don't take it otherwise. I think we have all enjoyed. Please give a round of applause for all the panelists. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much to all the dignitaries. Thank you. I must say that this was a very powerful and an insightful session wherein we got to know so much about the current policies and so much happening in the solar sector. So I big round of applause for these dignitaries out here. They really actually gave us a clear insight on solar energy. Louder, please. Even though so much is happening in solar energy, but all for good. Muskuraiye, aap solar energy mein hai. So now it's time for token of appreciation, and for that I would like to request our honorable chair and moderator Mr. Prashant to distribute mementos among our reputed dignitaries on behalf of EQ. Can you please come here, ladies and gentlemen? A little more energy and the clapping has to be there. All right, thank you, sir. Now I request Mr. Anand Gupta, founder of EQ, to kindly do the honor and give memento to Mr. Prashant. A little energy, ladies and gentlemen.